Good morning, children. Welcome to our next class. In last class, you learned about the creepy crawlies, how to categorize them, and what are the different body parts insects have. These all we completed, right? In today's class, what actually the insects eat? Look at this picture. What this mosquito is eating here? Mosquito is sucking blood from the hand. It's sucking blood. That means the food of mosquito is our blood. So in today's topic, today's class, you are going to learn about food insects eat. What type of food insects are eating and how different types of mouth parts they are having. How these mouth parts are helping them to eat their food, we are going to learn. Now, before knowing that, we will see the words what are given here in this particular LP. You can see very clearly the mosquito's picture here, how it is sucking the blood. Now we will move on to the next before activity. What actually the words are given, we'll see. The first one is suck. S-U-C-K, suck. Suck means to take in liquid into the mouth. Taking the liquid into mouth called as suck. Next word is P-I-E-R-C-E, purse, means to make a hole. To make a hole on the skin, known as purse. And the next one, G-E-R-M-S, germs. Germs meaning living things that we cannot see, but they can make us sick. The tiny living organisms which can't be seen, but we can look at them through the microscope. So these are the new words you are learning in this chapter, children. Nicely learn, those spellings are very important. Now we'll do one small fun activity. Before knowing that fun activity, we need the things like this. The squeezer, you need a squeezer, a straw, a cheese, and fruit juice. Any fruit juice, these are the things you take. And now we will try to eat these items. How to eat these items and what we need to drink the fruit juice. Can we drink this fruit juice by using a squeezer as shown in the first picture? Can you drink that by using the squeezer? It's not possible. So to drink the fruit juice, definitely we use the straw. So straw is very comfortable to drink the fruit juice. At the same time, can we eat this cheese piece by using a straw? Not possible at all. So we use the squeezer to eat the to eat this cheese, we need the squeezer or plucker. To drink the fruit juice, we need a straw. So we cannot drink this fruit juice by using a squeezer. In the same way, different insects have different mouth parts. Depending on their mouth parts, they are using their body parts and they are taking the food. Now we will see what are those different body parts, different mouth parts they have. We are going to see now. Now we will see how the different body parts are helping them to see. Once we'll see in the content book how different body parts actually the insects have and how they are helping them to eat their food, we'll see. Here you can see the butterfly. Which insect is it? This is a butterfly. So the butterfly can use, a a straw like mouth parts butterfly have. So by using the straw like mouth parts, they can suck the nectar from flowers. So they are using mouth parts to eat their food. Especially when you go for butterflies, they suck the nectar from different flowers. So they are sucking the nectar by using straw like mouth parts. And now when we see the housefly mouth parts, clearly you observe the housefly mouth parts. All type of food item, leftover food items, all houseflies can use. And it has spongy mouth that gives out a kind of juice. So it's the housefly mouth releases some kind of juice. So it helped the fly to suck the food. This was spongy, this liquid type substance making the food so soft. So that after making the food item into soft, then they'll suck that food. And houseflies at the same time, they are also carrying the germs from one place to another place. Whenever they are sitting on this food item, they are releasing some liquid from their mouth and making the food into soft. Whenever the food becomes soft, then they are eating. So at the same time, any germs, when they are present on their legs, those germs may stuck up to the food items like this. So that's why we must cover our food items all the time. Okay, and next insect is mosquito. You can see a sharp sting-like structures in mosquito's mouth. So very sharp stings are there because they are taking the animal's blood. Their food is animal's blood. So to purse the animals, pursing means making a hole. Just now you learnt in keywords, purse means making a hole in the skin. So they'll purse with the help of these sharp strings, they'll purse the skin and they suck the blood. So mosquitoes also carry the germs from one place to another place. That's why we should be very careful with our food items. Whenever we are eating, all these food items should be covered. Understood? Now we will see, we'll discuss we'll see the video what actually given here. This video.
A butterfly has a long tube-like mouth part to suck nectar. A grasshopper has teeth-like mouth parts to bite and chew. A mosquito's mouth helps it to pierce and suck. Different insects have different mouth parts that help them eat.
Understood, Chilin? You can see clearly the mouth parts of different insects and how they are helping once again in the video.
A butterfly has a long tube-like mouth part to suck nectar. A grasshopper has teeth-like mouth parts to bite and chew. A mosquito's mouth helps it to pierce and suck. Different insects have different mouth parts that help them eat.
Got it? So here, even the grasshopper is also shown in the picture. Grasshopper eat the leaves, so their mouth parts are also helping them to eat the leafy part and to teeth-like structures they are having. So with the help of that teeth-like structure, they bite the leaf and they chew the leaf and grass. And also wasp also there. One more wasp picture is given in your textbook. They suck the nectar, fruits, small insects also wasps are eating. They have a long tube-like and teeth-like structures. Because they are eating the fruits, at the same time they are sucking the nectar. That's why they are also having tube-like structure. At the same time they are also having teeth-like structures like a grasshopper. to chew the leaf, they are having all this. Now we will discuss our activity. Which insect has a mouth similar to the straw and the tweezers? A butterfly or a grasshopper? Why? You know, obviously, the grasshopper is eating the leaf, so it has a tweezer-like mouth parts, not the straw-like mouth part. The straw-like mouth parts, the insects which suck the nectar only have straw-like mouth parts. The mouth of a butterfly is similar to the straw because butterfly drink the nectar. So butterfly has straw-like structure, whereas grasshopper is having tweezer-like mouth parts. Why do insects have mouth of different shapes? Just now we discussed before starting the lesson, they have different mouth parts because depending on the food item, what they are eating. For example, if you see butterfly is taking nectar, housefly is eating different food items, mosquito is sucking the blood, and grasshopper eating the leaves, wasp eating the fruit, at the same time nectar. So depending on the food item what they are eating, their mouth parts are developed. Yes, so these all just now we discussed. Different shapes insects have because they are eating different types of food. To eat their food easily, their shapes are developed. For example, a mosquito purrs the skin of humans and suck the blood. So that's why it has needle-like mouth. Okay, a wasp eat all types of food. So they are having both teaser-like, teeth-like structures and also nectar. Understood? So now we will see, why do people get sick if a fly sits on their food? You know very well, just now I told you that whenever the housefly is sitting on food item, the small germs may stuck up to their legs. Small germs may stuck up to the legs. So because of this, the small germs may enter into our body also through the food items. That's why we need to cover our food items before eating. So the germs stick to their body parts. When flies sit on dirty things like garbage or drains, and they will come to our food items too with the same legs. They are sitting on the garbage, at the same time they may sit on our food items too. Whenever they are moving like that, the germs are sticking up to their mouth parts and also to their legs. When the same house flies sit on our food items, these germs may stick to our food too. So if we eat this food, we will become sick. That's why we must be very careful. Now we will see what are the questions given in this worksheet, children. What questions are given in the worksheet regarding food of insects, we will see. Food of insects have. First one, see, match the insect with the correct feature of its mouth. You need to match the insect, what type of food mouth parts they have. So once you see, butterfly is having long tube-like structure, or tube-like with a pointed end, or teeth-like structure. They are having, butterflies are having long tube-like teeth. Mouth parts, and grasshopper is having teeth-like structures, teeth-like mouth parts, and mosquitoes are having tube-like with a pointed end. Understood? Now circle the food that a ladybird eat. What actually the ladybird eats? Is it nectar, blood, or small insects? They eat the small insects, right? So the ladybird is eating small insects. And next you see bee bait. How does the shape of the mouth help the ladybird eat its food? A ladybird has a tube-like part or teeth-like parts in the mouth which help it to eat or chew the hard food. So a ladybird is having teeth-like structures in its mouth which are helping them to chew the food, not sucking. You can see the ladybird picture clearly. It doesn't have a sharp teeth-like structures. They are having teeth-like structures, not tube-like structures. So with the help of the teeth-like structures, they can chew the food. Understood? And the next one when you see, take the picture of the insect that can harmful to us. Which is harmful? Is it a grasshopper or the housefly? Grasshopper will not harm us because it just only eating the leaves. So housefly is harmful for us. You know why it is harmful? Because it sits on the heap of garbage. The germs are stucking up to their mouth and legs. That's why the same housefly, when it sit on our food item, it's harming to us. Now give a reason for your answer. That is the reason. Because the houseflies will sit on the garbage, small germs may stick to their mouth parts and legs. So this same housefly, when sit on our food item, the germs are entering into our food and making us sick. Understood, children? So write these answers in your workbook with your own words. What you understood from this, write this all. Now we will see the practice questions. What practice questions are given in this worksheet, we'll see. So the practice questions are, circle the correct food for a grasshopper. Is grasshopper eating grass, milk, nectar and leaves? Which is the correct answer? They are eating leaves. Why does a butterfly have a tube-like structure in its mouth? They are having tube-like structure to suck the nectar. So don't write a single word. You write a complete answer, children, by using your notebook. So second answer, you write in your notebook. And the third one, what type of mouth does a housefly have? A housefly is having spongy mouth. The housefly is having spongy mouth. So it can elaborate, it can open, and it can suck some juice from the mouth so that it makes the food item soft and then it suck the food. How can houseflies harm us? This already we discussed. They are sitting on dirty garbage and the germs may stick to their legs and mouth parts so that they are harming us. Understood, children? So complete your practice questions and the workbook questions and forward me, children. Thank you, and we will meet in next class.